Hello everyone, welcome to our fifth video of mathematical programming in Python series. In this video, we will look at one of the fundamental concepts of mathematical programming, which is called quadratic programming. Recall that in the previous video, we have visited the knapsack problem and modeled it using integer programming in Python. If you haven't watched it yet, you can click on the link above. Let us start with today's topic, quadratic programming. Quadratic programming is solving a mathematical optimization problem that involves quadratic functions, either in the objective function or the constraints or both. Quadratic programming has been widely used since its development in the 1950s, as it can accurately model many real-world systems. Quadratic programming is widely used in the optimization of financial portfolios, image and signal processing, regression, or scheduling in chemical plants, etc. There are many solution methods for this class of problems. Some of them are from interior point methods, or augmented Lagrange methods, or gradient-based methods, or extensions of the well-known simplex methods. The problem formulation is the following. Suppose that we have a dimensional vector x. Our problem is to minimize 1 over 2 x transpose times q times x plus c transpose x subject to ax less than or equal to b. Note that c is an n-dimensional vector, q is a symmetric matrix, a is an m times n matrix, and b is an m-dimensional vector. We have defined our general formulation. Now we can write down an example model and code it in Python using Gurobi. The model that we are going to implement is the following. We have a minimization problem where our objective function is x squared plus 2y squared plus 1 over 2z squared. And we have constraints. First constraint is x plus 3y plus 2z greater than or equal to 5, and y plus z greater than or equal to 2.5. We have lower bounds for x and y, which is 0. Additionally, we have an integrality constraint for y. Note that our decision variable z is a binary variable. Let us start with coding. First, we need to import our package. The process is pretty similar to our previous videos. If you haven't installed Gurobi and the package gurobipy, you can see that video via the link above. Second, we create a model using the model function and name our model quadratic. Next, we will define our decision variables, where x is a continuous decision variable with a lower bound 0. Y is an integer decision variable with, again, a lower bound 0. And last, z is a binary decision variable. In step 4, we will define our objective function, that is x squared plus 2y squared plus 1 over 2z squared, and set our aim as minimization by writing grb.minimize. Next step is to add our constraints, which are x plus 3y plus 2z greater than or equal to 5, and y plus z greater than or equal to 2.5. Now we are done with constructing our model. We can solve it by using the function optimize. The output shows the objective function value, that is 8.5, and the values of the decision variables as x equal to 0, y equal to 2, and z equal to 1. Let us learn how to update a model in Gurobi. Suppose that we want to change the type of the decision variable. Let y be a continuous decision variable instead of an integer variable. To do that, we need to write y.vtype equal to grb.continuous. After running this line, our model is updated and ready for solving. When we solve the updated model, our objective function value is decreased to 5, and the value of the decision variable y became 1.5. It became 1.5 as we allow it for taking float values. Additionally, we can add quadratic constraints. Let us add a quadratic constraint, that is x squared greater than or equal to y squared plus z squared. We can use, again, the addConstraint function to do that. After adding the constraint, we can solve the updated model by using the function optimize. When we do that, we can see that our decision variable x is changed. It has to satisfy the new quadratic constraint, which was x squared greater than or equal to y squared plus z squared. Now, our objective function becomes 8.25, and the decision variables become x equal to 1.8, y equal to 1.5, and z equal to 1. Thank you for watching our video. If you have questions, please leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and support us. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.